Well, very good evening, everyone. Welcome back to my channel, Devdeep Classes. So, those of you know me, my name is Devdeep Bose. I'm a faculty of computer science. Apart from teaching at my institute, Devdeep Classes, which is in Siliguri, I do provide coaching online via YouTube. So, if anybody wants to reach out to me, they can reach out to me at the aforesaid contact detail that is given below. And the contact detail that is given over here is my number over here. You can reach out to me over here. And these are the subjects that I do teach at my institute and as well as online. So without further ado, today I will be teaching you an important subject of your standard 12, that is economics. And the part of economics that we are going to study today is introduction to macroeconomics. Since you already know that in class 11 you had micro, so in class 12 we will be introduced with the broader aspect of economics, that is macroeconomics. So this particular topic, macroeconomics, and its introduction is from the book 1, that is macroeconomics. And out of that entire book, it will carry a total weightage of 2 to 5 marks from the CBSE class 12 perspective. Generally it ranges from 2 to 3 marks, but for safety 2 to 5 marks will be the way to go for in terms of marks distribution. So I hope you all must note down the marks distribution. Okay, moving on. The first topic is, what is macroeconomics? So basically, it is a branch of economics that deals with aggregates. Now, what is the meaning of the aggregates? Aggregates means collection of facts. So micro, where we are seeing a very minute level of inquiry. Like micro is like, suppose if I have this pen, so what is the cost of this pen? So that is become microeconomy. Do I have the paying capacity of buying this pen? So that is microeconomy, that is individual oriented. But now if I tell you, if all the people of India have the capacity to buy this pen, that becomes a macro level, because it is not only about me, it is about the entire population. So that is why we are calling it aggregate. Aggregate means collection of facts, and facts here totally pertains to a generalized audience or a generalized consumer. Now, as a matter of this fact, this word macroeconomics was coined by Regner Frost. Regner Frost was the main person behind coining of the word. But who is the father of economics? He is John Maynard Keynes. John Maynard Keynes is the father of economics because he gave the theory of macroeconomics, which we will get to know when we will understand about the macroeconomics more in detail. How did macroeconomics come up in this modern world? So then we'll get to know about the theory that is given by John Maynard. So I hope what is macroeconomics is clear to you. It is basically the branch of economics that deals with aggregates. Aggregates means collection of facts or generalized consumer audience, we can say. Now, what is the main difference between micro and macroeconomics? So microeconomic, first point, if you see, it is related to individuals' needs. So microeconomics is related to individuals' needs, that we can see here. So what is the meaning of individual needs? First up, individual needs mean the needs that are basically concerted with one person. Now normally individual needs are associated with, what are they associated with? They are normally associated with any particular person. Like suppose I was talking about that pen. Okay, so individual needs, particularly you can associate to that of a pen or any eraser that you are willing to buy, or any other person. If a person has the paying capacity to buy a car or a bike per se. But if I now tell you the paying capacity of entire nation to buy a particular car, that becomes an aggregated demand, a sum collection of demand, that goes to the macroeconomic point of view. So individual oriented, micro, generalized oriented, macro. Now the second, it is eccentric. Methodology is partial equilibrium. That means partial. We are thinking about only one dimension, that is either at your level or at your father's level or at your relative's level, where only one person and its needs are involved. So that becomes individual or partial equilibrium. But whereas if we talk about macro, it is generalized, as I told you. We are talking about a nation, we are talking about a state, we are talking about a country. So that is what is the macro level, generalized approach or the general equilibrium. Now the viewpoint also, there would be a difference. Whereas micro, we see it is instantaneous, very short dimension, almost minute in nature. We are looking at worm view level. But whereas bird's eye view will be the macro, because we are taking at a huge perspective. Think about my paying capacity to buy this pen. This becomes very minute because India's population is almost more than 13,000 crore. Okay. So we are looking at me, which is just not even a 0.4th of a quarter of a ratio. So my demand is very minute, very gross. But whereas we talk about all the population, that becomes huge. Okay. So that is the point of view or the viewpoint. And traditional example, as I told you, demand of a pen, salary of a person, that become micro. But national income, aggregate demand, that means demand of the entire citizens of a country, inflation, are all examples of the macroeconomics. Now, macroeconomy basically emerged when the laissez-faire. Laissez-faire is an approach that was given by renowned classical economists like Adam Smith, say Ricardo. Okay, so what is the statement of the laissez-faire? Supply creates its demand. That means if you have a particular supply, then only there will be a huge demand. Like for example, I have a demand for this pen. So if I continuously raise demand for this pen, suppose if I go to the shop and mujhe yehi pen chahiye, I want this pen only, then the shopkeepers will also try to inquire the company, no, we want this company, this model. So the supply will inflate in the market. Understood? So aisa hai ki mujhe ek particular product chahiye, mera wo demand hi khatam nahi ho raha hai, to supply bhi badh jayega. Theek hai? So that is the laissez-faire. But this laissez-faire approach was proved wrong, and particularly it was proved wrong during the Great Depression in the 1920s and 30s period. It happened in USA. So what happened? And that period, when the employment went down, because depression was there, people were losing its job, taxes were increased, companies were unable to keep a pace with their profit margin. So many people lost their job, there was unemployment. And since unemployment was going on, do you think there will be gross output, per capita output? No. So the aggregate output fell. And that was a testament that it is not only, see, at that time when there was unemployment, maybe there was supply, but there was no paying capacity to buy the good. So how will the customer buy? So there was no question of buying because they were not having the paying capacity. That brings us to a conclusion that output of an economy is determined by aggregate demand. Not just one person's paying capacity, not just one person's demand, but overall demand, overall supply. That is what the macroeconomic point of view is all about. It is not just demand of one person. It is not my demand that will increase the supply. It should be the demand of everybody. Then only this pain will be available, will be rather cheap for everybody to buy. Understood? So that is the concept of macroeconomic. And this theory was given by, this theory that I will just highlight for you, it was given by none other than John Maynard. Output of an economy is determined by aggregate demand, and this is called macroeconomics, and the father is John Maynard Keynes. He is the father of macroeconomics. So these are the things that you should note, and they are very important. So what did we learn about the theory of macroeconomics then? What was the reason it was developed? Because the laissez-faire was no longer suitable During the Great Depression, due to the increase of taxes, the price of goods went high, so the companies were unable to keep pace with the amount of tax being increased. People were losing their job because the financial standards were below. So, since there was unemployment, aggregate output declined. There was a steep decline of the curve. And therefore, what did we come to know? Not just one demand and one supply of a person. Demand of everything that results, every person, demand of every person results into supply for the commoners. Okay? So, that is what the theory of macroeconomics is. Now, what are the scopes of macroeconomics? Okay, why did macroeconomics emerge? What is the scope behind it? Now, first, it was national income. Factors that show how national income can be evaluated. Macroeconomics tells us how national income of a country will be evaluated. Now, next is inflation. What are the factors that creates a price hike? Okay, like increase of taxes is one of the factors we saw. Now, theory of economic growth that tells us how economic growth can pace up, what will be the effects of the economic growth. So these are the things that macroeconomic scope tells us. Now, theory of employment, what are the factors that create employment? Which factors will create employment? That is when there are higher demand of a particular product. So production has to increase. So laborers are needed. Laborers are needed. So therefore, there will be influx of employment. Trade cycle, that what are the factors that create import-export cycle of trade, okay? And finally, theory of monetary policies. What are the policies that are needed to be undertaken for distribution of money to a particular firm or an organization in order to do business? So, kaise money distribute karenge so that a particular firm can do business? Ek hi aadmi ko to pura paisa nahi laga sakte hai. Maan lijiye ki ek company mein अगर हम सेल्स के ऊपर ही पूरा इन्वेस्टमेंट कर दिए तो फायदा है, फायदा नहीं है. सेल्स को कंट्रोल करने के लिए एक और डिपार्टमेंट है, प्रोडक्शन में भी देना पड़ेगा. तो इंडिविजुअली हाउ वी डिस्ट्रीब्यूट द मनी एट डिफरेंट लेवल, दैट इज व्हाट मॉनिटरी एंड फिस्कल पॉलिसीज इज ऑल अबाउट. नाउ व्हाट इज द इंपॉर्टेंस ऑफ मैक्रो इकोनॉमिक्स? अंडरस्टैंड द फंक्शनिंग ऑफ एन इकोनॉमी. इकोनॉमी, हाउ डज इकोनॉमी ऑफ अ नेशन फंक्शंस? हाउ वी कुड कंपेयर विद द डिफरेंट इकोनॉमीज एट डिफरेंट लेवल्स, from the tertiary level to the primary level. Forecasting business plan. Macroeconomics is highly important for forecasting a business plan. Suppose today we start with initial investment, and if we continue with the investment or increase the investment, where will our company stand? Agar hum kitna investment hame rakhna chahiye taki company benefit ho, to ye sab cheez. And what are the economic policies we must formulate for our company to run better? That also macroeconomics will tell. However, the last two points are important because agar properly forecast karenge tabhi na hum log policies acche se bana payenge. So forecasting and modeling of policies are interrelated with each other. So I hope importance be clear hai aap logo ke paas. Agar koi bhi doubt ho, don't forget to mention in the comment section again. Now, there are different sectors from the point of view of macroeconomy. First factor hai firms. ये छोटा प्रोडक्शन यूनिट्स होता है, छोटा प्राइवेट ऑर्गेनाइजेशन या कमर्शियल ऑर्गेनाइजेशन, वेयर इन्वेस्टमेंट एंड प्रॉफिट मार्जिन इज लेस. सो बीइंग स्मॉल एंड टाइनी प्रोडक्शन इन देयर इनिशियल इन्वेस्टमेंट एंड प्रॉफिट मार्जिन इज लेस बिकॉज दे आर नॉट टारगेटिंग अ ह्यूज कस्टमर ऑडियंस. बट वॉट दे आर टारगेटिंग और वॉट देयर मोटिव इज रादर टू प्रोड्यूस गुड्स एंड सर्विसेज. ठीक है, so their main focus is producing goods and services for the customer. Now coming to household. Household is basically individual or a group of individual related. Like maan lijiye aap, main jaise ki aap logo ko service de raha hu, theek hai, coaching provide kar raha hu, that is totally a household. Because I will take the decision, I will decide how the consumer will want my content and how the consumer will respond to my products that I am serving. Okay, now many, like you see, many teachers are there who are teaching online. They go for prime, like you can say paid subscription. You have to do paid subscription of their classes, so that becomes totally profit oriented. So these are the things that how the, like you can see here, it is given how the consumption will take place. Household level, individual or group will take the decision, and how the consumption will take place, how they will pay the tax, how they will do the profit, it's totally up to them. So firm is basically a tiny organization, but it can be owned by many. And household, it can be a single or a group of individuals. It can be family oriented, it can be a friend zone oriented, or it can be you. You are deciding how you want to carry on. Now next we come to government. Government will always regulate and control the economy. They will frame laws. They will enforce how to practice these laws. Okay, like I'm giving you a certain example. Like the RBI is particularly rated. RBI controls the influx of money at different banks. They have framed laws. They make sure the laws are enforced. And if proper justice is not done in imposing, they penalize the banks also. So government plays a regulatory role, and they also oversee how the decisions are taken, how it is implemented, or case ye follow ho raha hai ki nahi. So these are the things that are followed. Example you can give is of RBI, and other factors also. Ministry of Finance can be an example also. Unhone apna law bana diya hai. वो लॉ उनको इम्प्लीमेंट करे, उसके लिए भी रेगुलेशंस है. एंड इफ द लॉज आर नॉट फॉलोड, स्ट्रिक्ट एक्शंस अकॉर्डिंग टू जुडिशरी विल बी टेकन. नाउ एक्सटर्नल सेक्टर पर्टेन्स टू मेनली द ट्रेड इनफ्लक्स एंड आउटफ्लक्स, दैट इज इम्पोर्ट एक्सपोर्ट. दैट हाउ डोमेस्टिक इकोनॉमी कैन बाय द हेल्प ऑफ हाउ वी कुड रादर डू द इकोनॉमिक ट्रांजेक्शन बिटवीन द डोमेस्टिक as well as the rest of the world, that is international. So the trade exchange between international and national or the grassroots level, that is import export, is basically the external sector of macroeconomic point of view. So I hope all these factors are clear and point of views are clear. Now what are the limitations? As I told you, macroeconomics has a huge scope, so it is not pertaining to individual behavior. Sometimes the conclusion that you will be drawing from macroeconomic level is inaccurate because it is generalized, as I told you. Some of your demand, like if we talk about a general demand, suppose today general demand of India is Jio is the best connection. Many of you might not agree with that, that no, we prefer Airtel, we prefer Vodafone. So these are the things. Sometimes it can be inaccurate to some persons. So again, you see, since deals with aggregate, so approximation of raw facts, real facts sometime will be not be answered as well. Like again, you all are telling that Jio is the best connection. Today we do a particular test and we find that Airtel is giving the best. So that is again a departure from the real fact. Okay, but due to the generalization, we did a market survey, it came out that Jio is the best connection because people voted for it. Now, subject to error and unambiguities, like the example again, the Jio wala example. You all, we did a survey and the customers of India have voted Jio is the best connection. But when we tested, we find other mobile networks are better than Jio. So again, it can be subjected to error as well. So with this, we come to an end of the lecture as well as the end of the chapter, that is introduction to macroeconomics. I hope the topics are clear to you. If you have any doubt in the topics, please feel free to ask your doubts in the comment section. And as a matter of formality, again, please do subscribe my channel, Devdeep Classes, for more videos on education related to CBSE level. And I will come up with more interesting lessons of different subjects. Today we had already discussed economics, so tomorrow we'll be dealing with another different subject from a different class. So as a matter of fact, thank you for tuning in today. I hope you have loved the lesson, and whatever doubts or queries do you have, you can reach out to the comment section below in the view. So thank you for listening to today's lecture. Hope you be glued to my channel for further future videos. Thank you so much.